Hugo, Ivana. Okay, let's start the class. For your information, our class or our online class will be recorded for documentation purposes. Okay, so welcome to MIS. I see familiar faces. Hopefully you are all in a good shape, good condition, and in a good health. It's so unfortunate that we could not meet face to face due to the pandemic and also restriction from the university on physical meeting. Hopefully it's just for a while and soon we can attend the physical classes in campus. Okay, just like regular classes, I suppose, although we have online classes now, we will treat it as it just ordinary class. It means that we will use Kuliah site just like before. You already familiar with this Kuliah site. Let me share my screen. Okay, so we will use Kuliah site as before. I think you already familiar with this. And then to replace our physical classroom, we will use Microsoft Teams. And I see that you already have Microsoft Teams. All the materials will be provided mostly in Situs Kuliah here, but some of materials probably will be available also through Microsoft Teams. The main part for document sharing will be this site. The meeting records, the video of our meetings will be available through YouTube channel. This is the channel. Okay, and the link will be provided both in here after each online lectures, and also within Microsoft Teams within our class. Okay, hopefully you already have the document that I share. Okay, starting from this, this joint code is only applicable for you if for some reason you are out of the class within Microsoft Teams. Okay, but I already put you into Microsoft Teams, so you don't need to join anymore. Since we are full online this semester, the official communication channel will be using either Microsoft Teams or your official student emails. Okay, and this student email also will open a lot of other resource or online resources within our university, like the library and so on and so forth. Now, in physical classroom, we have attendance system by using fingerprint that you clock in when you enter the classroom, and then you clock out again with your fingerprint when you are leaving the classroom. Now, for our online classes, I will replace that. The clock in will be you attend the online classes like this one. Okay. And then for clock out or attendance out, for each online meeting, I will provide small assignment that you need to turn in to submit the online assignment, online mini assignment within Microsoft Teams. So it's not using Kuliah site. Kuliah site is only for major assignment. So it will be available here in your assignment tab. Okay. I already set up one. I designed the mini, and for you, it's today is due 10:30 a.m. Western Indonesian time. And I designed the mini assignment specifically to be for you to be able to do it within like 1 hour. So it's a small assignment. Okay, we'll get back to this later. Okay, so it's probably a bit different mine than yours because students' view and lecturer's view will be different. But anyway, okay, so that's you will be considered attending online class if you attend the Microsoft Teams meeting and submitting mini assignment. Okay, so that will be counted as one attendance. Now, not all of our classes will be online. Okay, it's online actually, but not all of our classes will be using video meeting. Okay, university regulation only require to have online meeting minimum of 4 and maximum of 7. So online meeting is also called synchronous meetings. I design will be about 7 times, and asynchronous meeting will be the other 7. Okay, so what I just said about attendance will be applicable only for online meetings. Okay, for asynchronous meeting, I will give you some materials and some mini assignment, and when you submit your assignment, then you will be considered as attending that class. Okay, for online meetings, when the schedule of the next online meetings, please refer to the calendars part within your Microsoft Teams here. Okay, or within your Teams here in post tab, you will see also the next scheduled meeting. Okay, so if for the next week there is no scheduled meeting, then it means we will have asynchronous meetings. Okay, now you can turn off your camera if you like to preserve your quota or bandwidth. Okay, so I just need you to turn on the camera at the beginning of classes, so like 5 or 10 minutes, so I can see your face. Okay, right, so this is the online course instruction when we have online meeting. This is our semester plan. As usual, you can contact me. Unfortunately, since I'm working from home, this phone number and fax won't be able to be used to contact me. However, you can send me email or using Microsoft Teams chat like this. Okay, I have my Microsoft Teams application and email application installed in my mobile phone. So anytime you reach me through email or Microsoft Teams chat, as long as it's the connection is good enough, I will receive your message. Okay, so don't worry about it. And after all, I consider our classes is non-emergency or non-critical. So if you have something to ask me or something to say to me, in most cases, I believe we can wait for 24 hours before any reply. But I promise you, as soon as I can reply, I will reply to your message. Okay? Like I already said, that we will use this Kuliah site and also Microsoft Teams. This is the book. It's available here from the library, and this is the textbook. Okay, just one. However, I will give you other resources when necessary. The problem with teaching and learning MIS, unlike accounting information system last semester, The field of MRS is a fast changing field. Okay, so something new always came up every day. Therefore, even though the book that we use is the current textbook that we had, few of terms already out of date. So I will provide you with the latest information whenever it's available and relevant to your courses. Okay, so this is our plan. Okay, we will have 14 lectures, and the reference here, the number here refer to the chapter number. Okay, similar to last semester, your mark will be based on group and individual assignments, exam, and this is the mark. Again, remember that you need to submit your assignment exam on time. Okay. However, learning from last semester experience, I will make some adjustment. First, all major assignment, not the one that counted toward your attendance, will be submitted through kuliah site. Okay. So you need to submit your assignment or letter on the exam using kuliah site. Your exam will be on the in the form of take home exam. So you need to write something instead of answering short questions. However, you already knew that last semester, sometimes when required, kuliah site was not available. Okay, so if that's the case, we can use Microsoft Teams for assignment submission or exam submission. Okay, however, I will deal with that when kuliah site is not available. Okay, so we will arrange something. And don't worry, I will give you plenty of time to submit your exam, especially because I understand that sometimes there is a problem with the submission or connection. So don't worry, I'll give you plenty of time, just like last semester. Okay, so this is the all the materials will be here. Yeah, the main materials also to this lecture already here. Plagiarism, please be aware that it still apply. Okay. University library now have a software to detect this. It's called the Turnitin. How it works? Turnitin will examine your writing and then compare it to other writings that it has on database, including all resources on internet. Okay. And when Turnitin found similarities, they will report it. Of course, it's impossible to have 100% genuine work, pure work. It's impossible. So in general, you are allowed to have similarity to other resources as much as 25% of the total of your work. Okay. For illustration, all my writing, all my publication has been checked using Turnitin, and mostly it's under 20% similarities. Okay. My last publication that's published this month has 9% of similarity, so it's very small. How to avoid plagiarism? Simple. Whenever you use somebody else's work, acknowledge that within your writing. Okay. So, okay, that's it for our course online outline and our semester plan. Oh, sorry. Any question so far? Anything need to be clarified? It's clear. By the way, you
Yes.
can use, By the way, you can use raise your hand here to ask question or to interrupt me during the lecture, or you can use the chat, meeting chat facility here to ask question. Okay, so that's what we like. See, I'll raise my hand. Okay. If let me close this. Okay, so if you don't have any question, you can start the material for today. Okay, information system in business today. What's the difference? If you look at yourself, I saw a glimpse from your camera early on that some of you holding your mobile phone. Okay. So that's a common occurrence this day that we use mobile phone or mobile devices more and more. There is a growth in the use of big data. Okay, let me step back a bit. Last year, I don't know whether you attend that or not, our department held a seminar, and in that we invited people from Jarum and also from PricewaterhouseCoopers, and both are saying the same. Accounting profession is in danger. The danger came from replacing some accounting work with computers. Okay. So if you understand accounting as recording transaction data and then classifying the data, arranging the data and then reporting the data for as a financial report, then that work will be replaced by machine in no time. Conventional financial report preparation could take up to 2 or 3 months after the book close at the end of the years. But 10 years ago, Cisco, an IT company in the US, they use full computerized accounting information system. And then after the book close, they can produce financial report within just 1 week, and that 10 years ago. Okay, so it's probably just by snapping fingers, and then the financial report will be produced. So if you think accounting as preparing that financial report, that will be gone. Okay. however, it's not completely gone. Accounting profession need to change. And how? Accountant need to shift their focus from preparing financial report into analyzing and using financial report for decision making, especially business decision making. Okay, so that's how big data will play. Okay, let me. I believe you already familiar with this. Okay, this is the Tokopedia site that appears before me after I log in. So you see here, this is my my account. It's probably, and I think it's a good chance that this will be different from yours. Okay, why? Because my spending pattern, my shopping pattern are different from yours. Okay. And then again, that's come down to this, the data. Traditional accounting information system only record transaction data. So you sell something, you buy something. you have some fixed asset repair, things like that. You rent something. However, modern information system will not only record transaction data, but also interaction data. Let's take a sample of Tokopedia again. Tokopedia system will start the recording of your activities the moment you download and install that app. Okay. So you download Tokopedia and install it, and then whenever you open that application, the recording begin. They will record when did you open Tokopedia application, from where, using what devices, the time of the day, the time of the week, and what did you do? Did you browse through certain categories? Did you change from one categories to another? Or you just window shopping, opening whatever in front of you? And then they can also record what kind of product you purchase, when the product was purchased. So using this data, Tokopedia could predict, for example, when Indonesian public servant will spend their money in Tokopedia. They can see what kind of product the customer browse through before they make decision to buy. How many times you browse the categories before you finally make decision to buy. Things like that. So that's the era. We will explore this later. Cloud computing. Okay, we already used that. I think you're already familiar with cloud computing. You already live in it. These challenges create a lot of opportunities. Yeah, it's drastically reduced cost operating. I guess during the pandemic, you can see that people that lost jobs immediately shifted to other jobs, selling something, for example. Yeah. If you sell your product through online channel like Tokopedia, for example, it's almost cost you nothing. You probably need to spend time to prepare your product, take a good picture, and then upload that pictures to marketplace Tokopedia or Shopee, promote your product using social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, or you know, even sending message through LINE or WhatsApp group. But that's small cost. Okay. You already did that activity on daily basis. You just switch that activity from leisure to business. Okay. So yeah, it's almost cost that. Compare it to opening your own store. First, you have to find place. You have to rent that place probably. You have to change the place into a representable shop. You have to buy inventories. You have to create a good layout for your store, and that costs money, a lot of money. Some of the merchant in marketplace, they didn't even have the product. So they just, whenever order came, they'll find the product, buy the product at lower cost, and then ship it to you. You're probably familiar with the term dropshipper. That's how the dropshipper work. They don't have inventory. Okay. This is an old data, but still relevant. This is the US data. Okay. IT investment. There is a trend that IT investment now in the US companies amount of 33%, one third of the total capital investment. Why? Because corporation in the US switching from manufacture based operation to IT-based operation. A lot of companies in the US like Google, Amazon, Facebook, they don't sell product. They sell services, and those services require IT equipment, which is this investment. Okay. A lot of manufacturing company in the US no longer produce or assemble their product in the US. Apple, for example. Apple only design the product in the US for iPhone and iPad. The production itself done in China by Foxconn using components from Taiwan, Japan, and South Korea. That's why early on, the current US President Donald Trump asking Apple to move their factory from China to the US soil, Apple could not obey or could not grant that request. Why? Because it's very hard for them to move the factory. They can move the factory back to US, producing iPhone and iPad in this, but their suppliers are not in US. Okay. That's why a lot of manufacturing company in the US closed down because they moved the operation overseas. A lot of companies now can work as fully digital firm. I believe you already familiar with Netflix. Netflix is a full digital firm. Their product are digital, movies, documentaries, series. Their operation are fully digital. You sign up through the internet, you download their application, you watch their movies or series using digital application. You pay Netflix also digitally. So there is no direct interaction between you and Netflix, and yet both you and Netflix or us and Netflix has a business. Okay. So everything done digitally, managed digitally, the asset is also digital. Okay. Time shifting, space shifting. When we were forced to work or study from home, that happens. Yeah. We don't sit on the same room anymore. Sometimes even we interact on different times. You send email in the morning, I read it in the afternoon. You send it from your home, I read it on my home. So we are in different time and different space, and yet we can still work together. So how IT investment being used? IT investment being used for the six strategic business objective. Okay, to achieve this, I'll explain it a bit later. Okay. So operational excellence. It means that using IT, you can achieve better efficiency in your company. You can do the same thing, but with technology, it will be faster, more convenient, and cheaper. So you still keep your productivity, but with lower cost and faster speed. Let me give you this example. Few weeks ago, my wife lost her wallet. And inside that wallet include her national ID, KTP. In the past, dealing with lost ID is pain. Okay, so it happened to be that my wife is registered as a citizen at the city of Yogyakarta. So what we did, my wife found out that the city of Yogyakarta has a WhatsApp hotline, So she sent message asking how to replace her lost ID, and then came the answer within few minutes. What she need to do is to have police report. She already did. The copy of her old ID, if that's possible, she did, and also the kartu keluarga. She already had that also. So then the city of Yogyakarta asked her to come to City Hall in Timoho, and then she was asked to go through a drive-through. So replacing lost national ID can be done using a drive-through. So she drive into the post, submitting all documents, and then she asked if she could park her car and, you know, walk, and they said no, don't park your car, just move to the next station. So she moved the thing. In the next station, they give her the new ID, and it's done within a few minutes instead of days like the old days. Okay, and that's operational excellence. You lost your ID within minutes, as long as you have all the required documents, you will get the new ID. Simple. Okay. When I was applying for student visa to Australia 20 years ago, can you believe it? I have to submit all documents to Australian Embassy in Jakarta. I submit, I pay for visa, and then they ask me to return a week later. So I have to stay in Jakarta a week for that. Two years ago, when I have to go to Australia for some conference, I don't need to do that. What I did was opening Australian immigration website, creating account, select the visa type that I would like, fill in the form, upload all the scanned documents, my passport, my birth certificate, my national ID, etc., etc. And then I pay using credit card, submit the application, and after 2 working days, an email came saying my visa has been granted, and this is the number. In the old days, whenever I apply for visa in Australia, they will give me a sticker and affix the sticker into my passport. This time, no. They just give me the number, and I don't even need to print out that number. Australian immigration, when I was arriving in Australian airport in Melbourne, in Tullamarine, the immigration officer just scanned my passport, and that's it. All my visa information already there. So that's operational excellence. New product, service, or business model. Netflix. Netflix used to be a DVD rental service. They send DVD using post, and to compete with Blockbuster, the biggest DVD rental, movie rentals in the world. When I was in Sydney, I used to walk from my apartment to the campus. It's about 20 minutes walk, and all the way there will be 3 Blockbusters outlet. But then Netflix developed streaming services, and they can knock Blockbuster out of business. Blockbuster was bankrupt a few years ago. Look at the music store. When I was teenage, when I was younger, when I was university student, music store is a place to go, you know, to have fun, listening to new albums, buying some things. That nowadays a lot of music stores bankrupt, closed down, because they could not compete with streaming service like Spotify. increasing customer and supplier intimacy. It means that your technology is so good that the customer or supplier didn't want to switch. Let's take us for example as banking customer. I believe you have account in one or more banks. Why did you select that particular bank? Why not the other banks? Your reason probably because they have a good internet banking, because they have lower costs, because they have a lot of ATMs, because their ATM card are accepted for transaction in many places. That's technology. Okay, so you don't want to switch to other banks because when you switch, the other bank doesn't have as many ATM machines, the other bank doesn't have as good internet banking services, the other bank has higher fees, things like that. Okay. Improving decision making. This is a data-driven decision making. So we make decision based on data, not based on intuition, not based on you know, the voice from heaven or thing like that. Okay. So we use data to make decision. Okay. And our department is currently developing a new elective subject. It's called the exploration and data management. Sorry, exploration and data analysis. It will use teach you how to use data, especially big data, to make decision. And a lot of data out there that seems unrelated, but when you analyze those data and relate one to another, you can find surprise information that wasn't obvious before. Okay, so for examples, if somebody buying certain product, they usually also buy another product. This information can be used for promotion, for example. Okay, competitive advantage: you win over your competitor. You have better performance, you have lower costs, you're faster in responding, and so on and so forth. Survival, this is the last, you know, the least exciting usage of technology. ATM, for example. When Citibank in the 70s introduced ATM services, it was a hit. It was a well, it was so popular that other banks tried to emulate that, and Citibank was on top of their game at that time. Now, ATM is not something to win competition. ATM is a must-have for bank to stay in business, not to win competition. Let me give you this illustration. If you open an account in a bank, and find out that that bank doesn't have ATM anywhere, will you still open account in that bank? I don't think so. Okay. So if a bank has ATMs, they won't be winning the competition. Why? Because other banks use ATMs also. However, if the bank doesn't have ATMs, it's definitely that they will lose the competition. So for bank, ATM is a survival technology. They have to have ATMs just to survive, just to stay in business. Okay. I'll have my coffee. Okay. This is, we already have this, what information system is, what data is. I will introduce you to the concept of knowledge later on, and we will explore that further. Okay. And this is the system diagram where you have input, process, output, and then feedback. Okay. However, even though the principles stay the same, each information system will be different based on their organization and environment. Let me give you this example. Just a moment. Let's take example of internet banking. Okay. For security, every bank require us to have extra additional security measure. So when you want to conduct transaction over internet banking, either paying your bills or purchasing something or transfer money, you need to have additional security. BCA has this, the token. Okay. So whenever you want to have transaction over BCA internet banking, you have to key in the numbers that generated by this token. Most of the time, you have to key in twice. Okay, so for one transaction, you have to generate code from this device twice and put it into the BCA. On the other hand, Niaga, let me check this. CIMB Niaga have different strategy. Okay, yeah. They use text message, SMS. Whenever the customer wants to conduct transaction over internet banking in CIMB Niaga, before continuing the transaction, before executing the transaction, Niaga computer system will send code through text message. And then you have to enter the code into the application. Once, not twice like BCA, and it's using text message instead of token. Okay. And that's the point of this. Even though it's still in the same internet banking, it's capable, both Niaga and BCA capable of many similar banking transaction, but the way they conduct the process are different. Why? Because their organization are different, their environment are different. Okay, so information system is so much more than technology. Technology is easy. You have broken computers, replace it, fix it. If you don't like it, just throw it away. However, two-thirds of information system are consist of non-technical things, which is management and organization. And within management and organization, there are people, human, and dealing with human is quite difficult. People change their mind all of the time. People could be emotional. People could be unrealistic. People could be illogical. Okay, while the machine is predictable, logical, reliable, things like that. But the reality is these two parts will play much more significant and important role compared to the technology. You can have the best technology you can get, but if you don't fix organization and management, it will be useless. Okay. I will remember from your management courses, I guess, there are level of managements, operational, middle, and senior. The higher your position, the more concise the information that you receive. So senior management, for example, Pak, our rector, Pak Yoyong. Pak Yoyong doesn't need to know how many times a student skip classes, how many times student fail. He doesn't need to know that. Me, on the other hand, which or Bu Anas, who are here, or Bu Nadia, who are here, they need to know what kind of courses that you fail, what kind of courses that you need for next semester. Thing that they need to know that. Pak Yoyong, no. Why? Because Pak Yoyong are here. Okay. And also, its organization have a function. Remember the accounting information system, revenue cycles, expenditure cycle, human resource cycles, production cycles, things like that. Its organization have their unique business process. I already illustrated that with BCA and Niaga. even though it's same banking transaction, it will be done differently from different bank. Business culture, they are different. I don't know how active you are in the students union or students organization in this university, but later on, or maybe now, if you interact with students from other faculty, you'll see that their way of thinking are different from ours. Economic students, our faculty students will have different paradigm compared to say law students. Okay, so just different. It's not necessarily bad. Okay, and that will happen. Different peoples have different view, have different culture, and that's good as long as you don't turn that into conflict. Okay. When I was a student and the economics faculty campus was still in Merican, I can identify whether a person is a university student from Sanata Dharma or Atma Jaya. Why? Because Atma Jaya student tend to have their head high. Remember your first semester as the new students, how different your behavior compared to now. Okay. Unfortunately, this year we don't have the opportunity to observe the new students, but if we do have, we will see that how loud they are. Okay. So that's why in the US, the dorm for first year students are separated from second, third, or fourth year students. Organizational politics, this is how people in organization struggle to gain control and power. Okay, but we'll discuss that. But organizational politics is also a major factor in information system success. Okay, we will discuss that later. But technology dimension, okay, we also will. Now, hopefully by investing in IT, we can increase productivity, increase revenue, lowering costs, and have long-term strategic position, especially if our product or our system could not be duplicated, like what Google did, what Amazon did. It's very hard to duplicate them. However, investing in IT does not guarantee a good returns. Plenty of example that investing in IT does not result in a good business. And that's even for a big company. You probably still remember that Google had Google Plus. Google Plus is a social media that created by Google, tried to challenge Facebook, and it's failed. How many investment Google made for that? Plenty. Okay. And yet, even the mighty Google can fail. Okay. So how to use or to utilize this investment? We need to adopt the right business model and also investing in complementary assets. Let me give you this example. Gojek. What Gojek did in itself was not really spectacular. We already had Ojek for so many years. As long as I can remember, there were Ojek. Even Ojek with proper tariffs, you know that ordinary Ojek usually will check up the price, you know, play to the customers that they will charge customer more than a fair price. There is a Ojek service in Jogja, I remember that they use Argo just like taxi to calculate the cost. of traveling. So they have clear tariffs, this many rupiah per kilometer, okay, before Gojek, and yet it's not successful. The way Gojek operate, the business model Gojek operate, is also not new. It was a copy of how Uber operates. So Gojek just copy Uber, and then but they see that in Indonesia, the best option is not using car like Uber's, but using motorcycle, Gojek. Therefore, Gojek was born. And that's the right, adopting the right business model. They use Uber business model, adopting to Indonesian environment, and see that motorcycle is more dominant than cars, and also much more flexible, and obviously it's a lot cheaper. So they create Uber, Uber-like business using motorcycle instead of cars. Okay. However, it's not enough. Gojek also invest in complementary assets, their organization and management capital. Plenty of bright people were recruited by Gojek to build their companies. Okay. Tokopedia also did the same. Okay. So if you look at this, this is the return on investment for IT related investment. Okay, so it's mostly here. Okay, about 1% or 2% in return. Okay, not that much, but yeah, that's okay. As long as you have the proper complementary asset. This is the complementary asset. Okay, the most important complementary asset is the people. Okay. Gojek was introduced at the right time. Why? They use mobile phone, and a lot of people has already has mobile phone and familiar with how to use that mobile phone. Okay. If Gojek was say introduced 10 years ago, I don't think that will be success as today. Okay, so what's complementary asset? Organizational asset, managerial asset, and social asset. Yeah. Appropriate business model, efficient business process, incentive for innovation. That's why the startup in Indonesia try to invent new product, new services all the time, or they try to improve their process and their products all the time, because nowadays, we will later learn about this. If you have something new and it works, it's only a matter of time before your competitors will copy that and even improve. Okay. Look at Gojek and Uber. Gojek adopt Uber business model and improve it for Indonesia. So when Uber enter Indonesia, they could not compete with Gojek and Grab. Why? Because Gojek and Grab already improve their business process that Uber could not compete with. Okay, so they give up. Okay, now this is the last thing. So studying information system, we could not focus on technical side only. We also need to focus on social side, the human factors, because the human will use and utilize technology. Okay, so we need to deal with psychology, economic sociology. Okay, how sociology play into this? When you introduce a new technology, you will change the society, either in small scale or in a larger scale. So you need to understand the social environment where you want to introduce this new technology. Okay. Take this online learning, for example. I had one colleague that she already retired 3 years ago, and she said to us that it's lucky that she already retired, because if she was forced to use online learning system like what we did today, she will have a lot of difficulties. Okay. That's social side. Okay. We could not just abandon people that has difficulties in using technology in the name of progress. We could not let people who could not have access, who did not have access to technology, to stay behind. That's unacceptable. Okay, and unfortunately, there is a digital. You probably read a lot of stories about how students in many places that did not have internet access, having a lot of difficulties to study from home. Some teachers to try to replace mobile phone using radio communication and any other ways, but that's real. Okay, so we could not just abandon people who did not have access to technology, either financially, either restricted by age or restricted by other things. Okay, I will skip this. So the book that we use, it's use a socio-technical approach. So we need to pay attention to the social side, but also the digital side. This subject, MIS, this is the last slide anyway, will not turn you into an expert in IT. Far from it. Okay. What I aim to do with this course is to introduce to you what kind of technology-based business solution available and how to use and select them. So when you finish your degree and you work either as an employee, either as employer, either as business person or just ordinary employees, and you have business problems, you know what your option is. You know how much it costs. You know whether this investment is a sound investment or not. Sometimes IT people, IT experts, will exaggerate things. You know, they probably asking a device that costs 10 billion, while it could be done by device that would 1 billion. Let me give you these examples. For online learning, you need smartphone, right? I just learned that the other day that some students that in villages on the slope of Mount Merapi, they can use mobile phone, smartphone that costs less than $1 million. They don't need iPhone 11 XR or Galaxy Note 20 Ultra to learn. Okay, they can use devices that cost less than $1 million. I don't know what the device was, but it works. Okay, so from business perspective, cost is something that you need to consider, and that's my aim with this subject, with this course. Okay, that's it for today. Any question? Who is not attend this course? Let me check who is absent. Anyway, Remember that you have assignment, so you need to a mini assignment, so you need to do that. The other thing that you need to do for assignment is to form a group. Okay, I see that there are 8 people in these classes, 8 students. So please form a group of 2. Who is not attending today's lecture? Let me check. Oh, Felix? Felix is not here. Okay, anyway, he's not here. Form a group, and if one of you could not find a partner because Felix is not here today, you may join the other group. So there will be only one group that consists of 3 students, and the other should consist only 2 students. Let me know. The group compositions before the class that week. Just write down your name and student ID here, okay, before the lecture next week. And this is the assignment, okay. The assignment today is simple. Okay, so please make a list and specifications of the gadget or devices that you are using in this semester. So if you have a mobile phone, if you have a laptop, if you have tablet, listed them all with all the specification. Okay, I just need a specification that can be searched by simple Google search. So the other day, the student in the class asking, should they put the email number? And I said, no, don't put the email number. If you don't have the specification from your devices, just Google it for a while and then get whatever information, put it into the document and upload to assignment. Okay, any questions? So you need to submit your assignment before 10:30 today, mini assignment, form a group, and I'll give you the assignment next week. The big assignment, not the mini assignment. Any questions? Hugo, Erin, Fana, Rahma?
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
Good. I think no, sir.
Okay, good. You understand the mini assignment, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes.
So, okay. With that, I'll end our lecture today and our online meetings, I mean. And see you next week.
Thank you.